Hey there guys, I'm in my latest Datasmith scene, and if you haven't checked this out yet, you can see this in the Datasmith section of the course, which is newly added, and it's later in the course, showing the new workflow. But I'm going to just use this scene to demonstrate some common lighting problems and show you how to fix them. So this applies to all scenes universally. If you look in here, my lighting is looking pretty good. But one common problem that we always have is getting errors saying that our UVs overlap, right? You guys have probably all seen that before. So let's take a look at what is happening there. With Datasmith, when we bring things in, let's just go into this one static mesh here. Okay, as I've shown in earlier FBX workflows, in 3ds Max, it's pretty common to use the Uvw Unwrap Modifier to flatten all our UVs. So when we go into a static mesh in Unreal Engine, after importing that FBX, we can look here to the UVs tab and we can see the different channels. This one has like a million channels for some reason. UV channel 0 is usually the one that we use for the material. So that could be just a common box map out of 3ds Max. And then what I've taught you with the FBX workflow is to, on channel 2 in 3ds Max, which becomes channel 1, the second one in Unreal Engine, that's where you'd use flattening. Okay, so here's a flattened map, and you can see that these little faces are very small, so the resolution of that light map will be very small, unless we turn up the resolution really high for this particular static mesh. Okay, so I'll explain what that means. This is one UV square right here, and you can see that takes up very little of it. So we'd have to turn this up to very high resolution to get a good light map. And the light map is what is being used to show shadow and highlight and any lighting on this object. So that's what that unwrapped UV channel is for. Now, there's other channels here. That one obviously has overlapped faces. This is one face and it's overlapping that face. So that one's no good. And then this is channel 3. This one, I believe, is automatically generated by Datasmith when we bring it in. And you can see this one's really clean. Each face is laid out on its own. So when we apply lighting to this with the light map, it's not going to affect any areas that we don't want to affect, right? Each face will have its own light map area dedicated to it. So what we'd want to do is make sure that this one, so I'm not sure the history of this object and where all these came from, but I assume in Max I had a couple different ones generated, and then when I brought it in via Datasmith it generated its own, which you can actually do with FBX workflow 2. When you bring in FBX, there's a setting to generate UVs under dialog box for import settings with FBXs. You can automatically generate light map UVs there. Okay, and so they'll probably look something like this too. Datasmith just does it, which is great. Makes it easier. So what we want to do is make sure that the light map is using this proper UV channel. We can do that over here. And you can see there's the light map resolution as well. And I'll show you a little bit more about that. So right here, if we go in general settings and use the drop down, there's light map coordinate index. Okay, so the light map coordinate index is the one of these UV channels that the light map is going to use. Remember, each face needs to have a high enough resolution that it'll look good, and each face needs to be separated from each other so the light can be applied to it properly. So what we can do is make sure that it's on light map coordinate index 3, because that's the one that looks nice and clean for us. And then you can up the resolution here too. Okay, but we're going to talk more about that in a second. Now, you'll know that something is wrong with your light map UVs if you get an error, first of all, or when you bake your lighting, you see like a weird highlight coming across this wall or a weird shadow coming across this wall. Because you can see if this face was overlapped with this face, for example, that might be this face up here, and it's pretty dark because there's no light up there. And so if these were overlapped, you'd see that dark light from up here going streaking right across this face if those were overlapped. So that's what you got to watch out for. If you see weird highlights or weird shadows, it's probably a light map issue, and it'll give you errors when you bake the light too. So in here, what you can do is go to where it says lit up at the top left of your viewport, and we want to go to optimization view modes and go to light map density. Okay, so here we are seeing the pixels of our light map. Okay, so you can see that if this had a shadow casting on it, the shadow would be a little bit blocky because of that resolution, right? So what you can do is go back into our static mesh, and let's say we put this light map resolution to 1024 and then save. Now it's very high resolution, you can see, and it's bright red. What bright red means is that we might be going overkill with our light map resolution. Green means that we're in a safe zone. We're not too high and we're not too low, but sometimes I find it necessary to go higher than what is showing as green. Like here on that table, that's still kind of low resolution, and I want nice clean shadows being cast on this on the table. So another method to fix this could just be to go to the details panel for this particular object, and then we can just go down to lighting, and we can just check right here for override lighting map resolution. Okay, and right now it's set to 64, and you can just turn that up or down so that we get higher resolution on that particular light map. So right around, let's say 256, now we've got plenty of resolution that's going to be happening there. If we go into that object, let's look at what the unwrapping looks like. Our UV channels, number one, okay, this one's outside of the UV tile, so that one doesn't really work. That's probably our material. UV channel one looks really bad, but UV channel two looks perfect. Everything perfectly laid out. Now, if you do have overlapping faces, oh, one other problem that you might have is if these things are too close to each other, you can get the light from this one bleeding onto that one. So you'd get like a weird highlight around the edges or something, or a weird shadow around the edges because they're just a little too close together. So you need enough padding there. Okay, if you do have overlapping faces in here and you can't get them to look right, the best thing to do is probably go back into 3ds Max and manually unwrap everything the way you want, and then import it back into, or do a re-import back into Unreal Engine. But I have to say that the automatically generated light map UVs work pretty well. So there you go, that's how to fix some of those common light map issues. If you're getting that error commonly, and if you're seeing weird highlights, weird shadows, if you're not getting enough resolution in your shadows and things are looking choppy or blocky, hopefully this video will help you fix a lot of those issues.